Now, as Nigerians celebrate the new Democracy Day, our correspondent Maria Olaseyinde looks at the role Nigerian journalists who fought, died, and went into exile for June 12 they played.
There are many who believe that journalists are the real heroes of the June 12 struggle, as they spoke truth to power in order to expose the ills of the then military administration. MKO Abiola was also the owner of the nation's largest independent media house, the Concord Group, and widely believed to have won. These journalists who took the courage in the trenches to expose human rights violations are strongly opposed to the military being allowed to rule Nigeria again. Senator Babafemi Ojudu is one of the journalists who has lived to tell the tale of how he was arrested, tortured, beaten, and detained during the military administration.
In those days, you know, most of the things I see people writing now, you dare not write it without going to jail. Between 1993 and 1998, I must have been arrested and locked up for more than 15 times. So it was very harrowing. Sometimes you have to run away to go on exile. Many of those days, you don't even sleep in your house.
He passed through a bitter experience in detention at Shangisha.
You are taken into the prison and you are fed on a budget of 40 naira per day. 20 naira for breakfast, 20 naira for dinner.
Seye Kehinde, another journalist, also shares his experience.
We were very resolute because we believed that things we were fighting for that time, the democratic principles that we wanted in place, and we believed so much in it.
One journalist whose name comes to mind in the struggle is the then Kaduna correspondent of the news magazine, James Bagauda Kauto, who was gruesomely murdered by the military junta during the June 12 struggle.
We didn't know that in Kaduna, they have picked up Bagauda Kauto, who was the investigator of that story. And then, of course, you know, they went and tortured him until he died. A big hotel in Kaduna, there was a bomb blast there. They now carried his body from the mortuary, where they have kept it all this while, and put it at the scene, and put it, when you said the man died on his chest, you know, to show that there was a linkage between him, Soyinka, and the bombing of the hotel.
The Bagauda Kauto Press Center in Lagos, which was upgraded after 18 years by former governor of Lagos State, Akinwumi Ambodi, serves as a memorial for him. It's a moment of historical justice in Nigeria, but the restoration of democracy didn't come easy. It came on the back of a fight put up by unrelenting journalists who had no more than the pen. And in time, that pen has proved to be mightier than the sword. Maria Olaseyinde, TVC News, Abuja.
They believed in a good cause and fought gallantly.
Exactly. A lot of journalists actually paid the price. And there are a lot of unsung heroes amongst journalists.
Absolutely.
Of June 12.
Absolutely.